Let us understand how to configure trends and trend intervals for the variable tags in your project. To do this, let us open up the profile editor. As you see, the profile editor is already open here. Navigate to the device profile section. Click on add or edit. Here I choose the device profile for which the tags or the trend tags need to be added. Click on next. By default, there are certain tags like current, voltage and power for which the trends have already been selected. If you want to enable trend for additional tags, just check the trend checkbox for that particular tag. So let me do that for a couple of variables. Once you are done selecting the trend checkbox for all the interested variables, click finish. Now to select the trend scan intervals, you can navigate to the trend tag section and click on the individual variable or the trend to edit the trend interval. When you select a trend tag for a device profile, the tag will be normally scanned at what we call as the long interval. That is every 15 minutes with the first in, first out storage of 12 months. But certain tags can also have an additional short scan interval. This interval is set by default at 5 seconds with the first in, first out storage of 2 weeks. If you select the 5 second trending, there will be 3 storage files in rotation. As you see here, the number of files is 3. If you select 15 minute trending, there will be 13 storage files in rotation. Apart from this, you can also set up your own trend definition intervals. In order to do this, click on settings, set up trend definitions. You can click on new and set up your own trend interval or trend definition from here. Now to view all the trend tags in your project, you have to go to system model, navigate to system model and look at the trend tags. Each trend tag will have one or more separate files in which the trend tag is stored. So the PSO will continuously store trend data regardless of whether it is displayed on a graphics page or not. In the PSO environment, there are basically 3 types of trends that are available. If you look at the drop down, you can see that there is trend event, there is trend periodic, and then what we call as the trend periodic event. For the periodic trend, samples are taken on a time basis. If it's an event, which is a trend periodic event, one sample is taken each time a trigger action switches on. If it's a trend periodic and event, it is a combination of both event as well as period. You can also set the sample period from here. You can choose a lot of ready-made sample periods available for you, or you can put in your own number for the trend interval. So that is how the trend definitions or the trend scan intervals are selected in the PowerSkater Studio. Thank you for listening. Until the next time, see you later.